First antenna was non-functional, so Kareem's sending me to another one. If that one doesn't work, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I just hope Rice doesn't fuck me on this.
All right, we're back. Last time we left off, we were trying to work with Rice, so we were sent up by one of his allies to check out the antennas. First one's totally bunk. Let's see how we do with the second one. Ooh, zip. This is our first time on a zip line. That went smoothly enough. All right. Let's go for a leisurely stroll through the horrifying zombie wasteland and see if the next antenna works any bit. How far away is the next antenna? Map? Oh, we have a bit of a jog ahead of us, don't we? Ooh, and we have an airdrop. Let's go ahead and think about that. We can go, oh, airdrop stolen. Well, so much for that idea. Objective it is. Oh, whoa, I've been actually caught. I was not expecting that. Okay. Let's get some distance here. Close to an inactive safe zone, try to secure it. That is a good idea. You make good ideas. How, anyone nearby? Should be safe for a brief moment, so let's heal up. Hello, friend. Let's try to get you out of the safe zone.
Hey, Kareem, what do I do if the second transmitter's trashed?
The better question is, what will you do if you disappoint Rice? And the answer is probably, die horribly.
Okay, so how do I deal with this guy? We don't have a lot of options around here. Obviously, I don't want to get clubbed to death, so let's hop upstairs. Always a good idea to try to clear... Oh, shit. Oh, climb before something goes wrong. Climb? Okay. Let's see here. I have a Molotov cocktail. Let's throw it on the big guy. Hey, big guy. You're on fire. How's that working out for you? He's just gonna keep living, isn't he? Damn you guys. Please die. Please. Pretty please. The big guy's the real threat. Let's see here. So that didn't work out. What if I... Let's see. These firecrackers make them freak out, right? So let's try to get them to pay attention to the... There we go. Guys, look, a fire. Look at the freaky fire. Isn't that cool? Oh. Dangerous virals get their attention drawn. Oh, wow, they're killing each other. Well, that's certainly not handy. Hopefully no dangerous virals show up, though. Really, none of them died. Not even the guy that got clubbed by the giant. Pesky. Alright, well, I need to wipe these guys out if I'm going to proceed. There we go. Try to deal some damage before the big guy shows up. He's getting close, though. Climb up real quick. Don't want to hang out in his line of sight too much. Really? Really? The small one's still alive. Okay. Let's switch to something. Yeah, this one's got electric powers. Did that do any damage? Not really? Oh, there we go. That looked like an effect. Let's get some distance. Big guy's scary. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. He moved a bit more than I would have thought he would. Let's try to close this real quick. Yep, I had time for that. Oh, shit. Okay, I successfully avoided it. But I totally thought that I was not going to escape that. Blam! Explosive throwing star. Enjoy that. Hey, friend. Is she gonna go... Oh, she's... Oh, Jesus! I thought that was gonna work better than it did. Okay, let's get upstairs. Really? Even the normal-ass zombie was relatively... resilient to... Oh, shit. I'm so much worse off now. Oh, I meant to kick them. That was my bad. There we go. Big heavy club. This is not ideal. This is not in any way ideal. Shit. I'm out of combat stamina, which means I pretty much just have to run away. And my weapon's about to break. Oh, shit. Get off me. So I guess the noise must have gathered some virals nearby. Am I able to quickly change weapons? Looking at the map, no one seems to be getting closer, so... Sorry, if it looks like I'm doing maps wrong all the time, it's because I'm getting confused by the... Something about the controls feels a little weird. Let's see. What kind of modifications do I have in my party? Is there a better way to investigate these things? This one has lightning. These ones have... they're not modified, they're just stronger. Okay, so my strongest one is this 46 claw hammer. Let's go ahead and equip that. The rebar I'm going to hold on to because it's probably useful. I just want to repair it. This knife's kind of shit, so we're just going to dismantle it. I need things in my inventory that I can more effectively fight with. Go ahead and bring that claw hammer with us too. Okay. Hey, friend. Ooh. Take that out. Oh, there we go. How's that feel? Get upstairs real quick. Oh, I'm not climbing properly. Shit. Ah. Well, this is nice. Looking here at the vendor, they sell a plain hammer, for which does 68 damage. I think I'm going to go for this. There we go. This will be my first chance to have a truly strong weapon. So, let's try to modify this weapon. What can we do with our upgrades? So, Assassin, 13 handling. Versus Bruiser, which is 10 damage and 13 handling. Not bad in general. Let's go it. Bruiser. Confirm upgrade. So, this is going to be a scary, scary hammer. And it looks like I can repair it 4 times. So, this will hopefully give me a better chance at clearing that place out. How do I get out of this place exactly? Is that the door? I believe this might be one of the safe houses I cleared out. I think so. I don't know, this closed off area mixed with this open area looks like that, but I could be wrong. Anyway, let's get out of here. So my goal is to... yeah. Let's try to get back in the area that I screwed up in a second ago. Ow! That hurt. Didn't plan on that hurting as much as it did. Ah, fuck it. I'll use a med kit. I have an abundance of med kits right now anyway, so things could be worse. I just need to get in the groove of this game, I think. So a lot of games have a bit of a learning curve, and there's very specific ways how things work in this game. From the inventory to the crafting to which weapons are best used when you should conserve. One of my concerns, of course, is like, I'm like, oh, cool. There's valuable strong weapons. That's interesting. Oh, but those valuable strong weapons have limited durability and will one day just break forever? Oh. Alright, so the door's still closed. That's good news. So if I barge in there, we have to fight the same people, looks like. It's, Can I jump through here? Nope. Okay. Gonna have to jump around real quick. I'm gonna try not to use an explosive this time, because that seems to have paid off poorly for me last time. Huh. Yeah, looks like the exact same people are here again. It's weird, because I did kill some of them, I thought, but okay. So, let's try our awesome new hammer. Oh, right, I have an unspent... oh, God, what happened? How's it going? Wanna have fun with that fire over there? Oh, he's just gonna run straight at me? Hey, friend. Oh, God! Yeah, I don't know what I was expecting to happen there. So I think both of the gas mask guys died in that horrible explosion that I sacrificed myself in willingly. Yes, it was a clever ruse. Hello, friend. Dodge! So my advantage here is that this guy's slow. Hook! Ow! But I was not out of range there. My mistake. Alright, so, what's he doing? Dodge? I just need to cape out of his melee range as best as I can, while hoping that we don't somehow attract unwanted attention. Oh! These guys, they definitely go down slowly. I like to avoid the brutes as much as possible, but obviously here I'm not given it much of a choice. I will say, holy shit, your weapons definitely degrade very quickly compared to how many zombies you actually managed to take out in that time. Oh, there we go. Actually got 2 swings in before things went sour. Run back. I have to be careful not to dodge into those spike balls that I think killed me before. This guy's never going down, is he? Oh, now I'm missing. Coolio. That makes it really feel worth it. At least I'm getting a bunch of experience or something. Yeah, I'm getting like 30 experience per hit. What's he doing? Is he gonna charge me? What is this? Did he stomp? What, does zombies have stomp powers? Is that like a legitimate thing he can do? Ah, there was an airdrop nearby that got stolen. It's a bummer. I do have like kind of no sense of how much health this guy has, huh? Dodge sideways. Hit him a few times. Come on. Noise draws... Oh, come on. Noise is drawing attention? I'm not even making noise. Oh, that thing's on fire. Is it gonna blow up? At least he's dead. Is this now a safe area? Did I win? Let's go ahead and search. Have to be careful, because virals are gonna come in. What do I have to do to establish this is a safe zone? Oh, shit. There's a target sign's over here. There we go. Oh, here come bad guys. Shit, don't come in time. Please. Yes! Safe zone unlocked. They didn't make it in time. That was very close. There was guys... They're actually retreating. The AI's retreating out of the safe zone because they kind of walked into it when they weren't supposed to. That's right. You can't come in here. Arbitrarily. You're arbitrarily not allowed to come in here. So suck it. I'm gonna take this giant rebar as a reward. God. Damn, they take a long time to kill, don't they? So how do I... Can I jump up there? There we go. Alright. So now that that's taken care of, right back to the target of trying to do the second antenna. Man, I thought that was just going to be a really quick, minor detour. But me trying to just take over that one little area turned into quite the ordeal, didn't it? My bad. Search this place real quick. Did I get anything out of that? I'm not sure. I felt like I had to move before because I was being followed. Metal parts, good. Doing quick scavenging as we wander through, just because that's pretty much the way to go. Alright, approaching the antenna area. Oh, don't go over this wall. Okay. That's it. That wall was going to be a lot more of a drop than I was originally anticipating it would be. Oh, it's a drop down. Don't want to go that way. That is not an ideal path, because I might not be able to get it back up, and I get the feeling the antenna is probably going to be up here somewhere. Oh, another brute. Because of course there is. It's a brute. It's a fireman brute. Why are they turning things that used to be good for us? They're making them bad for us. It's like some kind of weird social commentary or something. What's that? Oh. Oh, there's someone in danger over here. He's in severe danger. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Get out of here. Can I get away with repairing real quick? Without you guys fighting? There we go. Repaired. Hey guys, see, you're kinda doing bad things, and I like work for the military, and I'm not cool with that, so I'm gonna have to deal with you. Oh, incoming zombies. That'll be a nice surprise. Oh, these guys are resilient, okay. Let's see, what can I do about... Oh, okay. The surprise is behind me too. Oh, you intentionally let me walk into that, didn't you? Well, how about exploding star? Oh, he didn't react to that very well, did he? I guess non-zombies don't react well to explosions. Okay, now I'm gonna attack my volatiles. These guys safe? Oh, the survivors died. Oh, that's a bad guy. What? Well, explode, bad guy. Oh, why didn't he explode? I hit him with an explodey bit, didn't I? Well, this didn't go well. Okay. I'm just gonna go ahead and get out of here for now, because that did not go as I envisioned it. Apparently the survivors just straight up died, and I'm being attacked by a volatile now. Is he coming up behind me? Hello, friend. There we go. Is that making good progress? I'm trying to finish. There we go. Took him out. So I thought it'd be a heroic and rescue some survivors from bad bandits. Not so much.
Cream, I'm at the second antenna tower, and the fence is electrified. I think someone's inside.
That will be Alexei, and probably his son Christoph. I find him tiresome. Don't let them stand in your way. You've got to get inside and turn on the transmitter.
It really does take an eternity to kill some of these guys, doesn't it? I'm really hoping that changes over time. Or that I'm just fundamentally, like, I'm not understanding something, hopefully. Because holy shit. That's a lot of blows to the head. You'd expect a smart blow to the head to take care of things. Can I not scavenge him? Guess not. Okay, so fence is electrified. I need to move fast if I'm going to get in and out. I'm trying to get in and out before it becomes nightfall. What time is it? Oh, it's 8 o'clock. I'm screwed. I am so screwed. Okay.
What do you want?
Well, if I avoid... Are they going to attack me, or are they going to let me come in? I don't know. Hopefully the electrified walls means it'll be harder for it to be attacked by volatiles at night. Hey, friend. Can we talk?
I need to climb the tower.
Why the hell would you want to do that?
For Rice. He asked me to.
Rice? You don't look like one of his crew.
Oh, fine. I'll just radio back and tell Rice that you wouldn't let me through.
What? Fuck. No. I didn't say that. You want to climb? Fine. Go.
Well, I'm glad we could reach an understanding and they're not going to be obstructionist about this. Do you want to talk?
I don't care who hears me!
Please stop. What's wrong with you? We're trying to stay alive here.
Dad, these guys are killers.
Yes, they're murderers. So we work for them. That's how we stay safe.
Talking about how horrible Rice is in general, it sounds like. And he doesn't like the fact that we're rolling. Oh, really? This is closed? I can't just go up the ladder? Of course not. Okay. Let's do some climbing. I mean, how dangerous could it be to be on a tower at night? Can the volatiles climb all the way up to the top of the tower? That'd be a concern. But if they can't, then I'm safe. Really? Is this close too? Can I climb the outside? Hang on a second. Oh, wait, how do I get higher? Oh, climb outside. There we go. It's definitely an interesting experience climbing these buildings, because you can't mindlessly do it. You have to actually look around for specific objects to let you move forward. Here we go, a ladder that's actually open. It had to happen sooner or later, right? Otherwise, they're just teasing us. And nobody likes a dirty tease. Can I climb that? Yeah. Jump across, don't die. Every jump is just tense. Like, well, this is not gonna work for me, is it? I'm going to die horribly now. Can I catch this? Please catch it.
I sure hope this fucking climb was worth
it. Okay, I almost died. Okay. Turns out, just like in Mirror's Edge, first person climbing's a tad awkward because you're not always sure what's gonna happen. Okay. Where do I go from here? Looking for yellow handholds? No handholds. That's a closed ladder. There's no rim on the outside. It didn't let me grab this Oh god, I fell. Damn you, first person. I need to figure out what the hell I can climb to get forward. Alright. It's a really bummer I can't use this ladder. So I can't... Can I not catch this? Oh, I can. So something must have just gone wrong last time. Weird, okay. Can I jump up there? It's not gonna let me climb any higher, apparently, for some reason. So I must have to jump across. Okay. This could be a mistake. Oh, it didn't work. Okay, now I'm getting frustrated. Go ahead and turn on a flashlight, because it's getting dark here. Oh, can I jump higher? No, I can't jump higher. Oh, I'm dead. Okay. That's great. Well, the good news is they spawned me back at the tower when I died instead of in the middle of nowhere. The bad news is this seems to be the only thing I can climb on, and that's how effective it is to proceed. So I can't really go anywhere at all. There's not really... Yeah. Well, fuck. I guess I'll have to wait till morning because I can't go outside right now unless I want to get assaulted from all directions. There's a note. Note number 23. Alexei, my husband. We have both seen enough of our friends destroyed by the sickness to know that my fate will be no different. In a very short time, I will turn on you and Christoph and perhaps harm you both. I can't allow that to happen. I am sorry that you will have to find me this way. Please don't be mad at me. I love you and Christoph above all things, but I must do what I must do to protect you both. Now promise me that you will do what you must do to protect Christoph. He is too young to understand the consequences of recklessness, and the world has become too unforgiving of mistakes. Find safety, wherever it is, and stay there. Make peace with it. Ignore whatever flaws you will quickly come to see, and make the best of the situation. It's the only way you can survive, and that is what I want you for you most. I love you. Farewell. Maja. Oh, so even these people these random people we see that just don't like working for, like, their only character trait right now is just that they don't like working for Rice. But hey, even they have their own dark history. Let's wait till morning. Alright, so I waited till the morning, and we're at a brand new day. It looks very foggy, even windy. I actually was getting some controller vibration, presumably from the wind itself. So let's hope that I have better luck today at climbing, because yesterday was a bummer. Particularly because at one point I fell all the way down to the bottom, and that totally screwed me, because as far as I can tell, you have to jump into the area from the outside and meet them the way I first did in order to climb higher. If you're on the ground floor, they seem to have forgotten, like the level designers seem to have forgotten to put in a platform that you could use, which is really unfortunate, because as far as I could tell, there was no way to climb the tower from the bottom. You have to do it from the outside of the area. Please, oh Jesus. I was really convinced for a second there that I wasn't going to catch that. So, call me crazy. I feel like the only way to proceed from here, let's check this. No. Yeah, can't do that. As far as I can tell, the only way up from here is this long vertical thing. Like I'm supposed to jump out and catch it? So I'm really frustrated because a second ago I didn't get it. So let's try again. Please work. Oh, thank goodness. It just kind of works sometimes, but doesn't work. Oh, right. Here's where I am again, where I don't know how to proceed. So I tried jumping forward and I fell. And I died. I tried jumping that way and I don't think I made it. So what do they want me to do? So I'm getting a little frustrated with not having a clear direction to try to proceed in. Because falling to my death because I can't figure out what to do next is kind of frustrating. I'm going to try jumping diagonally to that, maybe? Please? Oh god, it worked. Why did it work? I don't know. I'm not sure. I guess as I play this game for longer, I'll have a better feel of what does and doesn't work. But right now, I'm still in the early stages where enough stuff can just kind of go wrong in frustrating ways. And it doesn't always feel like it's my fault. Part of the learning process, but still, I'm being punished for learning, and that's not always super fun of an experience. But we're climbing the tower now.
Hey everybody, how you doing?
Oh, look at this little beam out here. That's a very Assassin's Creed moment. If you want to synchronize your map. Definitely, that does not seem to be the way to go from here, though. I assume the radio tower thing must be up there, so... Wait. Wait. Am I currently getting a symbol saying that it's below me? Sorry. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Oh. Is this it? Oh, here we go. I was going too high. My bad. Come on, open. Please. There we go. Alrighty.
And this thing's still intact. Let's see if it was worth the hassle. Hey, Kareem. Second transmitter's up and running. Is it working? Kareem, do you hear me?
Loud and clear. Nice job. You know the way back, right?
Right.
Success! This one's not busted all to hell. Alright, let's get hop right back down. Did I just set a waypoint over there, or was that already there? I saw it pop up dramatically. Alright. So let's go get our payment, and hopefully they'll cooperate with us and not totally screw us. Man, they're far away.
It was you, wasn't it?
Raheem?
The antennas. Bracken told me. Communication is crystal clear now.
Yeah, that was me. And now I'm on my way to see Rise again.
And get the antis in?
That's the deal.
Good job, man. This helps everybody, but especially Dr. Zera and Dr. Camden. They can hear each other without static for the first time since... whatever. See you back at the tower.
Be there as soon as I can.
Well, hey, just like previously predicted, setting up, it turns out fixing the antenna the antenna really helps everybody. After all, I doubt that Rice has any particular power over encryption, for example, and so I don't think he can monopolize a tower like that. But my guys can take it. So since it's in his best interest to have it working, and he sent me to do so, that means my guys can use it. So we've established
Hey, Greg, I got a second. I want to patch through to somebody who really wants to talk to you.
Huh? Who?
Is this Kyle Crane?
Who wants to know?
My name is Troy. I lead a small group of survivors over in Sector Zero. We call ourselves the Embers. Sector Zero's completely sealed off. Mr. Crane, until you restored radio communication, we didn't know if anyone else in the city was alive. I just wanted to let you know how grateful we are. You've given us a small measure of hope.
Well, I'm happy to help.
If there's ever any way we can help you, Mr. Crane, please, don't hesitate to ask.
Well, there we go. So not only has establishing cooperation helped my part, I have completely lost track of the correct direction to enter this place, haven't I? Not only have we made things better for the people we're working with, but we actually managed to establish communication with brand new people. And that's always good. Oh, here we go. Good. I'm not completely lost. So we've established communication with brand new people, which is good. From a story perspective, that just means another quest hub, probably, but it means potentially more allies that aren't psychopaths like Ryze. So maybe more reasonable people to work with.
The job's done. Now it's time to get back to Ryze and get that antizin.
Are you guys prepared to love me for my deeds?
Or are you guys going to betray me again? Oh, that's Ryze. I'm sure talking to him will go over great. He's not a psychopath or anything.
Well, you not only did the job Karim asked of you, but you made it back in one piece. Bravo.
Can I get some antizin now?
Did you think I would be satisfied so easily? You still have plenty to prove.
Look, we really need the drugs. Let me have them now, and then I'll come back and do whatever.
You'll get antizin when I say you get it, not 1 second before. But, as I have established, I am not unreasonable. Do all that I ask of you, and I will give you not one, but two crates of antizin.
All right, fine. What do you want me to do?
This will be different from your exploits on the antennas. It will require a bit more persuasion. The imposing of one's will, the creation of one's own rules, that is what makes a man. Do you live by your own rules, Crane? Or are you merely someone else's puppet? I believe I know the answer. Talk to Karim before I decide you are no longer worth the trouble.
I believe I don't like your tone.